Where's my lights at then? I didn't know it was going to get damn dark out, though. Let me just bring up my, hold on here, man. I didn't think it was going to be getting dark that quickly. Hold up. Put some damn lights on this bitch and have a look at this game, man. The full version of this game is absolutely ridiculous. And it's head over heels different from the tech demo that we were playing. So I'm very, very excited to be showing you guys some BeamNG content on this here. This is my first time actually on this. So I really don't know what to expect. Now, in terms of our selection, we're going to go with the 427. And yeah, I'm hyped right now. I really am. We're going to have a quick look at customization. And, you know, I cannot wait till this game is fully out. Again, this is not even a full game, guys. And you guys got to understand that, because this is... Oh, we have a racing wheel? Okay, never mind. We're just going to leave that the way it is. Okay. Have a quick look at that wheel, though. That is dope. What happens if we go to racing wheel? Okay. Didn't really change much, I'm not going to lie to you. The steering wheel actually does not change, which is okay. You know what I'm saying? Front fender, can't really do nothing with that. I wish this thing right here would go away, though. You know what I'm saying? That's just, like, in my way, man. Chrome striping. Oh, okay, okay. We're going to take this damn hood off, though. How dope is that? Oh, my God. Look at that V8 just poking out. I am down for that. Oh my god. Okay. Differences between the two. And if you guys have anything to input on this game, do not hesitate, guys. Let me know in the comments below as well. Always taking, you know, questions, you know, comments, concerns, all that good stuff. Now, just right out of the box on this modification, I'd have to say that this is, you know, it's a very nice looking car. You know, if we get inside of this here, you know, really close, the bay has a lot of detail to it. You can see that clear 427 right on the damn air intake on that carb right there, and just absolutely looks clean. No complaints about this car. I mean, even the interior looks really nice. See that beautiful shifter in there as well. Rims look great. I'm glad that there is customization on the rims, which is, you know, a big thing. You know, I don't like using those stock rims on this game, so I'm glad that they had an additional rim with the radials. Love it, man. Absolutely love it. We're gonna drop the clutch on it. Let's see what happens. Okay, never mind. Not much. I guess I had the parking brake on. Is that what happened? I'm not liking how the gearing is. And for whatever reason, it is on manual gearing. But it's looking to go straight to fourth gear. And I don't know why that's happening. That could be the differential that we have on here. So we're going to go ahead and change out this diff quickly. Put that original differential back in there. We could have actually left the diff empty, which I'm curious to see what would have happened. Probably would have just, you know, like taken it right out, and then that would have meant we had no damn spin. This Nova is insane already, man. Seems like it has quite a bit of horsepower, but I'm just curious on these gears. I mean, it's going straight from either fourth to third gear, which is kind of worrying me a little bit. Look at that, third gear right away. Ooh, we're just going to be drifting this park right now. And this thing is getting sideways, man. Not too shabby on this fourth gear. You know, the fourth gear is really the money gear for this thing. Overall, though, I am liking it. Now, my up on my D-pad. Oh, we're going to fit right through there. Woo! That was damn too close. Now, I do have a couple surprises for this episode towards the end of it. So, make sure you guys stay tuned for it. Look at this, we got some grass patches here. This is the ultimate testing ground. And this thing is loving the grass. Look at this. No holds barred right now. Rear end just slipping right the hell out on us here. Oh, look at these jumps right here. These ramps, I don't know what they are. Oh, this Nova's just taking it like a champ. Get some speed on this jump. Here we go. Oh, shit. We're holding it. Oh, my God. God! Oh, shit! Nova, though, my thoughts on this Nova so far, the car feels great. Again, it really comes down to just being able to use this car a little bit better in terms of gearing. And I don't know if that's just me, you know, not knowing what the hell I'm doing on this game. But I just feel like I should have a little bit more control on the gears and, you know, being able to throw this a little bit more sideways. I mean, it looks great from right here. But that's really about it, and I mean, I can't dig in and I can't kick it out like I want to with the clutch. It just kind of grips back up. So hopefully you guys can let me know in the comments below, is it me, is it the car, or is it, you know, just everything in general, man? I don't know. Let me know. My gearbox does say manual transmission, so do not get me wrong on that. I do have the proper transmission on here. It's just not working, man. I don't know. Let me know. Now, car number two up is the Fury right now, and have a look at this monster, man. This looks like something out of a damn old school cop movie. Probably was, to be honest with you. I don't know these classic cars too much in terms of movies that they're in, but it looks hella damn familiar, though, and it looks gorgeous as well, too. It's just a huge boat, probably, you know, weighing 4,000 pounds with a V8 manual transmission in here. So this is no joke right now, man. I mean, you can see this thing definitely wants to get sideways. I'm hoping that we can adjust some of the parts to, you know, help it, give it that little extra push to get there. So without further ado, let's go into the parts configuration and let's see what we can do. Now, let's just take the body right off, have a look at this chassis here. And I should have done that with the Nova, but looks clean, looks nice. I'm gonna throw that back on because I do want to see that. We're gonna take off our hood, I think. No. I actually want the hood on for the Fury. Just my personal preference. It's my forte, you know what I'm saying? What the hell happened there, man? Stop. Get off the car, bro. God. Okay, though. Front tires, we're gonna go with front sports. What is that gonna look like? That looks like no tire. How the hell are we supposed to be driving with? Hopes and dreams? Like, what is this? Let me drive with it. Oh my god, they're just not rendered in. They are there, but for whatever reason, we can drive with no damn wheels though, man. Look at this. Hell yeah. You can see that chassis just twisting, which is absolutely amazing to see on this game. Let's take this thing on some damn jumps, man.
You ever been off any sweet jumps, Napoleon?
Here we go. Holy shit. Thing is a tank though. It's still going. And this actually gets hella more sideways and more torquey than the damn Nova was, man. Look at this thing. After just going, you know, 20 feet in the air. Unbelievable right now. Let's restart this. Now, I don't know offhand, but I'm almost certain I may be able to use my steering wheel with this. So if I can, you know, let me know in the comments below. I'm going to be looking it up as well, too, to find out, because that would be incredible to be using a damn steering wheel with this game. Where's my steering wheel at, man? It's not even here. That's some bullshit right now. Oh, shit. Okay. Now, the Nova could not make it up this. I want to see if the Fury can. Hopefully, we can stay on it. Oh, boy. I'm not even doing it. I'm not doing it. I'm backing out. Oh, shit. Okay. Just messed up that rear end right there. Okay. Oh, my God. What is that? Really, once you get into that second gear, and that's where you can really get this car going. Oh, shit. Braking on it is mint, though. That was incredible right now. God damn. We'll say these damn models take a hell of a damn beating and just keep going. Let's see what happens when we get to some serious damn... Oh, my God. Land it. Oh, my. Jesus. Car's so heavy, it just lagged my whole game, man. And look at this. That is right through the block of this damn car, man. Something went right through my block. Oh, my God. The engine's toast, even though my fan is still going. Hey, man. I don't know where the hell this is going, though. Almost destroyed that thing. Here we go. Oh, my God. What is this? To nothing. What if I would have made that? Oh my God. The Pontiac Trans Am right now. This thing looks like it's going to be a little bit of fun, man. Now, obviously, I don't think it's going to be as fun as the Fury or the Nova, but I may be mistaken. Now, right offhand, I can see here the engine and the transmission does not look to be as powerful as the Fury or the Nova, but that could be just because of the fact that we are on some serious bumpy ground. So that could be a possibility as well too. I'm curious to see what this thing can be done in terms of the parts config. So let's have a quick look here and have a quick check. Let's have a look at the chassis here. Let's see. Okay. No motor, no transmission. That looks gorgeous, man. 6.6 liter. Whew. I'm losing money just idling right here is what's going on. Supercharged V8. Oh, I want to be able to hear this damn supercharger or else I'm going to be a little bit upset. Just a little bit. Look at this thing. Oh, there's our wheel though. Now, if you listen closely, we should be able to hear. What the hell is going on? It's got a dirty limiter on here, or the gearing is just ruthless. We're in neutral, apparently. Don't ask me any questions about that. I don't understand that at all. Is this water? Oh, shit. What the hell is that? It's like quicksand. It's a woo, woo. Like, come on, man. That is probably some of the worst gear changes I have ever seen by any person driving a damn vehicle, man. Let's see if we can change out this, this transmission and see if we can maybe fix this, because this is brutal, man. Let's put in the 3-speed. I'm praying that this fixes it, because that is just horrendous. They need to work on their gear changes on this game. I don't know why, but I just am having no luck with these gears. I mean, oh, shit. Is that my intake? What the hell is that? Came right off my damn car, man. Oh, my God. This game is too real, man. If we had these style physics and, you know, the ability to take away parts like this in, say, Forza and, you know, other console games, oh, man, would change the entire world of the gaming community. Oh, shit. That came down real hard right there. Look at the chassis right there. That is some real world damn physics. And, you know, they have done amazing things with this game. Look at the jump drift. Oh, we're going to connect that. I don't know where the hell we're going. How far is this thing, man? Are we going to go to Wonderland? Let's see how fast we can get this up to. We're on like the damn salt flats right now is what we're on at all. Going quick though. 103. I don't think this car has even seen this fast before. Look at that whole frame. It's just the structure on this car is not safe. And we're doing a top speed run right here with this Trans Am. Oh my God, I'm about to throw this sideways once we hit it. Look at this. Oh my God, that's the end of the map, I think. Here we go, 144 miles an hour, sliding sideways. Whew! Okay. So for one final testing on this episode, I want to take this to a map and see how these cars can actually maneuver through some obstacles and terrain. So we are going to be doing a test lap on BeamNG's track that they have put in the game for us. So, I'm pretty hyped right now to be doing some laps on here. I have not done any type of circuit racing on BeamNG. So I think this is going to be a lot of fun. We're going to be testing all three cars, one lap apiece. You guys ready to drop the clutch on this thing? Hopefully it's not even going to, it's probably not even going to do anything though. Check this out, ready? Starts in fourth gear. That's smart. Oh my God. We got some idiots behind the damn wheel right now. Oh shit. You need ABS or something, man. I don't know if this is going to be a drifting run or what, man, because shit. Got a little bit sideways, so that's one spin out for the Nova right now. That's not good, man. We're not looking too promising right here. I'm just going to keep my finger off the right stick because I keep moving the damn camera and it's screwing me right the hell up right now. Oh. Come on, Nova! Look at this. What a recovery by the Nova! And this thing is just straight tail happy, man. I cannot stress that enough. I mean, if you're looking for a car to get sideways, go and pick up this Nova. I will leave all the links to the mod download page in the description box down below. But these front tires don't even want to catch grip on the counter steer, though. Jeez. I don't know why I went in here, but it worked. There we go, a little transfer. A little grass life, no big deal. I don't even know where this track even goes to. Oh my God. I really wish I had control of my gears is really what I would love to be able to do for next episode. I gotta figure that out if we can. I'm sure there's a way to do that, because it is definitely screwing me up with the amount of damn steering that we have on this thing. God damn, man. So up next, we have the Fury It did quite well in our testing area, so I'm hoping it's going to be able to throw down a clean lap. That's the plan on this car, but again, you know, nothing really goes as planned here in BMNG. But let's see what we can do, man. Here we go. Spinning rubber right away on this thing, and we just got to make sure we can hold this. Brakes are hopefully going to be okay, but these brakes, man, are doo-doo sauce. I'll tell you that right now. Fury's looking good. This is where the Nova screwed up. Handling on this thing is not bad, man. Unbelievable on this section right here. Coming in hard on the brakes. Not too bad. Try to kick out this rear end on the clutch. Oh, look at us go right now, man. This Fury is loving life. Throwing it in. We're going to do the same route as we did with the Nova. This Fury is damn near perfect right now. And look at the angle that we're getting with this thing, man. We didn't spin out, though. It fully countered. It was just a little bit harder. Oh, come on, baby. See, that's where I need that clutch kick, man. I need to be able to drop a gear and just clutch kick it back in. We're not going to do very much in fourth gear right there. But we will finish with a damn near good lap, though. That was incredible by the Fury. Hell yeah, man. I did not expect that from there. Last but not least, the Pontiac Trans Am right now. We had a little bit of trouble on this in the testing area, so I don't know what's going to happen with this. We had a lot of issues with our gearing just going straight to third gear. Look at this. As we're sitting in neutral, we're in third gear right now. Look at, oh my God. Ladies and gentlemen, one lap for the Trans Am in 3, 2, 1. Go. Look at that. $6,000 letting it go straight into first. Look at this. Nobody can drive right now. We're going to just lightly throttle this here. Try to get it to go. Oh boy. This is damn near scary right now with this Trans Am. I feel like this thing is going to fall apart. Ooh. Absolutely horrid right now, man. Can't even keep it on the road. Gearing is just going straight from first right to third right now, and I mean, I don't know right now. This is not the greatest damn car for sure. Now, every episode, we are going to be taking these cars to this track as, say, the proving ground. We may switch up to different tracks, but I really do like this track just because of the fact that it is very simple, has a good combination of, you know, stretches, of corners as well, too, and to really fine test this car in terms of, you know, what it can do. And the Trans Am is just not there, man. It does not compete with any of them. Personally, I mean, I do not like this car at all. It's just not the greatest. I mean, if you guys have been able to figure out this thing and, you know, actually be able to get this thing to properly handle, I don't know if it's just me mashing the throttle. I mean, let's have a quick look here to see if it's a little bit different without it. And I mean, still, it's the throttle, man. You need to be so light on it. And on these cars, man, all I want to do is just, you know, hold gas and spin tires, and I just cannot do that. So out of the three cars, would I recommend the Trans Am? This is my answer right now for you guys. That is a no, man. I did not like this car at all. Really just didn't have the proper physics engine that I was looking for. I mean, even from anywhere from the, you know, the gearing and all that, I just wasn't a fan of the car. So for that reason, this thing is going to get destroyed right now. I don't know where we're going to push this, but it's going somewhere. And that's the name of the game, man. If I don't like it, it's getting destroyed right now. And hopefully we can pin this against a tree or something. Oh, yes. There we go. Get it. Just squish Trans Am right now. Here we go. Hell yeah. Just breaking damn shit on this game. And I love BMNG, man. Absolutely love it. And I will say, you know, after it's all said and done, we are now stuck to this Trans Am, actually, which is, okay. Look at that. Oh, get off me, bro. Get off me, man. Look at this. Where are we taking this thing? Oh, my God. There we go. It's gone. All right, guys. So after vigorous testing of all three vehicles, I think it's a pretty clear shot right now. The Plymouth Fury, I mean, for me, did it. And that's why that is my top pick for today's episode. I just felt like the car overall was a great build. It handled very nicely, and it did win the lap on the track. So, you know, I feel like it's fitting. The Nova was great, and you guys can see that thing just kind of underneath our damn steamroller with the Trans Am somehow. I don't know how that happened, but it did. All right, I ain't gonna ask questions. It's there though. But as I said though, the Fury just held its own, and I think, you know, it was really the clear winner out of all of the competition. I mean, it just outshined everybody. And I mean, even on the track, it was great. You know, it had the horsepower when it was needed. The gearing was very nice. Differential was great as well too. And that is why the Fury is taking home today's winner on Beam NG Drive. Would I recommend the Nova? Yes. Would I recommend the Trans Am? Probably not. I didn't really like the way that car was set up in terms of the file itself. It just overall was not the greatest experience for me on Beam NG. You know, the transmission was whack. It was not the greatest build that I've seen on this game. So for that reason, I'm going to not recommend that for this episode. If you guys did enjoy Beam NG Drive today and want to see more, don't forget to hit that damn subscribe button down below and become a member of Team Slap today. As well, too, guys, you can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, all of which can be found in the description box down below. Ladies and gentlemen, Jabuta Slap Train, I'm out. Peace!